Hello and welcome to WPKlik's YouTube channel. In this video, we're going to talk about adding an interactive checklist to your site or blog using a plugin. This is a nice addition to any site and can be used for shopping lists, packing for vacation, holiday planning, organizing events, and whatnot. For this purpose, we recommend an excellent plugin called Frontend Checklist. The first thing to do, of course, is to install the plugin and activate it. Once you got all that sorted out, head over to the settings and click on Frontend Checklist. You will see a simple options panel which contains several different shortcodes. The only available option here is the new checklist. Click on new checklist and enter a checklist name first. Don't worry, the name of the list won't actually appear on your page. The description field is optional. Again, the text you insert here won't show on your page and only serves for easier management of multiple checklists. The items part is an important one. That's where you actually insert your checklist items. You can add up to 50 items, which is more than enough. Additional fields open up as you go through the list and fill the item fields. If you wish, you can also use basic HTML in these fields. For instance, if you want to emphasize one or more words in bold, put it between the B tags, and for italic, use the I tags. Once you completed your checklist and inserted all the items, the next step is, naturally, to add it to a page on your site. Frontend Checklist offers four different shortcodes. The first one, Frontend Checklist Name equals Standard, is used to add a checklist to a page. Make sure to replace the name attribute with the name of your actual checklist. You can also add checklists to widgets using the text field. Of course, only do this if it makes sense for you to place the checklist in your footer or your sidebar. The next shortcode option is Cookie On or Off, and it is extremely useful. Basically, it helps you set whether you want to save the checklist for future use or not. If the cookies are on, the status of the checklist will be saved for logged-in users, and it will be able to pick up where they left off before refreshing or leaving the page. If you don't want this functionality to be enabled, if you want to display a blank checklist each time, simply turn the cookies off. The shortcode is Frontend Checklist Name equals Checklist Name, Cookie equals Off. You can even set a cookie lifetime using the Days attribute. Simply add the number of days you want your cookies to last, and note that the default is 365 days. The shortcode is Frontend Checklist Name equals Standard, Days equals Number of Days you want. Another interesting option you can use is to offer a link to the PDF version of your checklist. That way, your visitors, once they've completed the checklist, can save it on their computers or print it. This is particularly convenient for shopping lists, vacation packing, and so on. The shortcode for this is Frontend Checklist Name equals Checklist Name, Type equals PDF, Title equals My Checklist, Link Text equals to the checklist. The download link will be located below the checklist. You can change the default link text to the checklist and replace it with your own text. After you have set your checklist, you may want to customize it and make it more fitting to your website. If you want to customize the appearance of your checklist and its items, you need to add HTML tag span to each of the items and define the class. In this case, the class is MyCList. After you have inserted HTML tags, you'll need to define what the items in the MyCList class will look like. For that, you need to add a few lines of CSS, which is very simple and doesn't require any particular knowledge of this language. Just follow these steps. Go to Appearance, click on Customize, and then on Additional CSS. To your left, you'll see a field in which you can enter your CSS, in our case, the MyCList class. You can follow the live changes in the field to the right. Go to the menu and find the page your checklist is located. Here, you can add some code to change the font color, size, family, weight, text shadow, and padding. You can check out the article linked in the description of this video and just copy the code. Paste it to your additional CSS field and just change the values to fit your needs and preferences. Note that you will have to pay a lot of attention to the structure of your code if you want everything to turn out right. The class is defined as class name. Of course, you will probably have a different name that you will use instead. All properties are placed between curly brackets, and the properties are added as property, description of property, and this is the structure that absolutely has to be followed. Another interesting thing that you can set is to make checked items different from the unchecked ones to make the distinction even clearer. To do this, you will add properties to the checked MyCList class. Like unchecked items, the checked ones will have text decoration line through which crosses out the checked items. As you can see, it's all very simple. Just follow the code structure, experiment, play around with properties, and make your blog stand out with this cool and useful addition. We hope you found this tutorial helpful. For more information about this topic, check out the description and make sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel.